हम शंकराचार्य मध्यमा अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरुपरंपरा श्रुति स्मृति प्राणानाम आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ नक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तमा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण्डमिदधाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्ह देवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशमुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आम्नायान्तिकसंसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। The fourth sutra is introduced by saying Purvam prane manaso vrittilaha uktaha. So we have seen indriya, vrittilaya in prana, in mana, and mano vrittilaya in prana. So prane manasa vrittilaya uktaha. Then further, what does the mantra say? If you go back to the mantra, you see अस्य सौम्य पुरुषस्य प्रयतः वांग मनसि संपद्यते मनः प्राणे। सो फार वागेन्द्रिय चक्षुर्यादि इंद्रिया ऑल्सो हैव वृत्ति लय इन मनस नॉट स्वरूपलय। एंड सिमिलरली मनसः लय इंटू प्राण मनोलय इंटू प्राण इज ऑल्सो वॉट इट इज ओनली वृत्ति लय नॉट स्वरूपलय। फर्दर दि मंत्र से प्राणस्तेजसी तेज परस्याम देवतायाम। सो प्राण तेजसी संपद्यते, देर इज प्राणलय इंटू तेजस। नाउ वेदर दैट इज वृत्तिलय प्राण वृत्तिलय और वेदर इट इज स्वरूपलय। सो पूर्व पक्षी हैविंग सीन दैट वृत्तिलय इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड बाय द सिद्धांती, ही सेज दैट सिमिलरली वृत्तिलय प्राण वृत्तिलय इज देर इन तेजस। सो ही सेज पूर्वं प्राणे मनसो वृत्तिलय उक्ता तद्वत् तेजसी प्राणस्य वृत्तिलय अस्तु। लेट देयर बी वृत्तिलय ऑफ प्राण इंटू तेजस। सो तेजस इज अग्नि रूप एंड व्हाट इज इट, इट इज प्रकाश रूप ऑल्सो। तेजस इज अग्नि एंड इट इज प्रकाश रूप एज वेल एज हैज हीट। सो इट इज इट हैज प्रकाश एंड हीट बोथ एज इट्स गुण, दैट काइंड ऑफ तेजस। Unto it let there be vritti laya of prana, says the Purvapakshi. Pranas tejasi iti shrutehe. Why he says pranaha tejasi? It is in continuation with the earlier two parts of the mantra. Therefore, similar interpretation should be there as you, the Siddhanti, has established. Iti shrute iti drishtant sangatya idamaha. He says that the exemplified third part of the mantra should also be in keeping with the earlier two, as you yourself established the earlier two. And thereby adhyakshadikaranam is being looked into now as to so adhyakshetadupagamadibhya. So adhyakshetadupagamadibhya, says Bhagavan Sutrakara. So that laya saha adhyakshe tad upagamadibhya is a single word, bahuvachana, panchami bahuvachana, hetu. There are multiple hetus. First among them is upagama. We'll see the hetus proper and what the meaning is there with what quotation is given in the vritti. But currently sutra artha is what? Saha. Saha ka pranaha. Tejasi sampadyate means tejasi adhyakshe sampadyate. Adhyaksha, teja adhyaksha jiva is the meaning of tejas. So along with tejas, there are other mahabhutas also, which are pancha mahabhutas sukshma. So sukshma mahabhutas, what is called a bhuta sukshma. With that bhuta sukshma, jiva has, like sukshma sharira, he has abhimana. So similar this bhuta sukshma, he has abhimana in. So one who is dying, or one who is an upasaka, or one who is a jnani, so far the krama is same. But then later, based on the marga taken by the ajnani jiva, he'll have a different gati. Upasaka going to Brahmaloka will have different gati, Uttarayana Marga, and Parabrahma Jnani, Nirguna Brahma Jnani will have no gati. All his components, meaning all the Mithya components, Sharira, सूक्ष्म एज वेल एज स्थूल, स्थूल एनी वे लाइक दी मृता लाइक एनी वन एल्स, स्थूल शरीर विल ईदर बी बर्नड और विल बी बरीड, सो इट विल एनी वे डिजॉल्व इन टू इट्स कारण. बट सूक्ष्म शरीर विल ऑल्सो रिजॉल्व इन टू इट्स ओन कारण, ईच कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ द सूक्ष्म शरीर विल रिजॉल्व इन टू इट्स ओन कारण. This is the real laya. So what has been said there is vritti laya. So far it is only vritti laya. But now when prana goes into the mahabhuta is actually what? Where there is abhimana of the jiva. In the case of an ajnani, this sukshma sharira where there is abhimana of the jiva, they both are tied together till the brahmajnana takes place, videha mukti takes place. So that kind of a jiva along with tejas etc. will travel. That is the entity who has gati, who has samsarana across shariras. So when a general krama is mentioned of laya, laya krama, there prana tejasi liyate, sampadyate means liyate, that time what exactly is happening? There is swarupa laya of prana into jiva, adhyakshe, says the sutra, says Siddhanti. It'll be clearer when we look at the vritti. अत्र पूर्वपक्षे तेज शब्दस्य मुख्यत्वम्. पूर्वपक्षी सेज तेज मीन्स फायर, अग्नि. सिद्धांति सेज ओके इट मीन्स फायर बट इन फायर देर इज नो प्राण लय, नीदर वृत्ति लय नॉर स्वरूप लय. इन व्हाट इज इट देन? इन जीवा हु इज एसोसिएटेड विथ नॉट ओनली तेजस बट ऑल दी भूत सूक्ष्मस. सो सिद्धांति भूत उपहित जीव लक्षकत्वम इति फलभेद कस्य? तेज शब्दस्य. So teja shabda here means, teja shabda means this jiva who has upadi of teja adi bhuta, teja adi bhutas. So bhuta, pancha maha bhuta sukshma where he has, which have become indriyas etc. Indriyas, and all the manas ityadi, the entire set of components which makes up the sukshma sharira, there he has abhimana and therefore it becomes upadi. That jiva is the meaning of teja sabda. So in teja there is laya, that means in jiva who is associated with teja adi bhuta sukshmas, there is laya of prana, and therefore siddhante teja sabdasya bhuta upahita jiva lakshakatvam iti phalabhedaha. So there is a lakshana you have to do. You have to go from teja shabda, mukhya meaning is teja mahabhuta, but it is not only teja mahabhuta sukshma amsha, it is all the mahabhutas, because it teja is upalakshana for others, and via that there is a lakshana done into jiva, because the laya of prana cannot be in agni, there is no connection at all. Prana and agni have no karya karana ityadi bhava, and prana vritti also, if you think of vrittis, prana vrittis are prana apana vyana udana samana, those vrittis cannot have laya in agni. So it means into jiva, where the sukshma sharira karana is this avidya. Karana sharira is the karana for stula and sukshma shariras. That is why it is called as karana sharira. The avidya is called as karana sharira for that very reason. And with that avidya, this jiva has abhimana. Therefore, with the karya also, he has abhimana in the bhuta sukshmas also, which have created the sukshma sharira. So sukshma sharira is due to avidya and its components are bhuta sukshmas. And this is how the entire, it is all a prakriya. There is no idam ittham really there. But we have to understand for what it's worth to see that jiva meaning is what you have to land on with tejas shabda. And in jiva the prana laya is not prana vritti laya, it is swarupa laya. Thereby, प्राणस तेजसी इति उत्तरवाक्य किम प्राणस्य लय तेजसी उत जीवे इति संशय तेजसी इति पूर्वपक्ष. सो इन तेज और इन जीव, दैट इज द आइडिया हियर. नॉट ओनली वृत्ति लय स्वरूप लय इफ इट इज देयर और वृत्ति लय वेयर इज इट. सो सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द आक्षेप इज वेदर इट इज इन तेजस और इन जीव. पूर्वपक्ष सेज इन तेजस एंड देयरफॉर सिंस द अर्लियर टू लयज आर नॉट स्वरूप लय, दे आर इंद्रिय लय इज नॉट इंद्रिय लय रियली, इट इज इंद्रिय वृत्ति लया एंड मनो लया इज ऑल्सो मनोवृत्ति लया. देयरफॉर प्राण लया ऑल्सो लेट इट बी प्राण वृत्ति लया. Siddhanti says, no, it is jiva. So Siddhantastu sa pranaha adhyakshe jive. Adhyakshe means jive. Nivritta vritti hi san avatishtate. So prana vritti goes away and prana has is merged into this. So san avatishtate means nivritta vritti san jive avatishtate. So prana is not outside, like indriyas still remain. Chakshuradi or vagadi indriyas still remain. That is not the case of this prana. Prana does not remain separate from jiva. It gets merged into jiva. Therefore, it is swarupalaya. Nivritta vritti. So, nivritta vritti is bahuri. Nivritta vritti. Yasya pranasya sa prana. Yasya pranasya sa prana. Nivritta vritti prana. So, that prana is nivritta vritti. Whose vrittis are gone, whose divisions are gone, and that prana, jive, san, jive, adhyakshe jive, leenaha avatishtate, that's the meaning. That prana merges into jiva and remains with jiva. Kutaha vai so, kutaha tam jivam prati upagama anugamana, anugamana avasthanibhya. So, upagamadibhya hetu was given. There are at least three hetus. So, three hetus are given. Upagama, Anugamana and Avasthanibhya. These are the three hetus. What are these? So the meaning is given. Upagama, approaching. Anugama. Actually, Anugama also can have a similar meaning of approaching. But we'll see the difference given with quotations. Evam evam atmanam antakale sarve prana abhisamayanti. So they approach. All the pranas approach antakale at the end moment, at the maranakala. In this manner, AMM, in this manner as explained there, they approach who pranaha, sarve pranaha abhisam samayanti iti upagamaha. Atmanam, kam abhisamayanti, they approach the jiva. Atmanam here, atma means jiva. They approach all the pranas, approach the jiva to merge into that jiva. That is upagama pramana. Then tamutkramantam prano anutkramanti. So here anu. Anugamana means Anupaschat, so paschat gamanam. Upagama is approaching near. Anugamana is following. So anugamana is also pramana. What is the anugamana shruti there? Tamutkramantam pranaha anutkramati. So anutkramati, anu. Paschat utkramati. Prana goes following the utkranta of someone. Who is that? Tam. Tam is tam jivam, atmanam. So tam jivam, jivatmanam. Utkramantam, that jiva who is leaving the sharira, the prana also goes along. That is the second pravana, anugamana. Avasthana is the iti anugamanam, and avasthana is the third hetu. Savijnano bhavati iti avasthanam. Savijnano, savijnana is vijnanena sa, and vijnana there is vijnanam maya abhimani jiva, that jiva who is savijnana. Prana also becomes savijnana. Vijnanena jivena sa. So vijnanena vijnanam maya kosha abhimani jivena saha savijnanaha bhavatika pranaha. So savijnano bhavati iti avasthanam. This is the avasthanam. Where, how does it stay? How does this prana stay? Jivelinaha. So one who is with jiva, that kind of jiva is vijnanamaya kosha abhimani. So savijnana is along with vijnanamaya, meaning ajnanamaya jiva, who is ajnani really, because he thinks himself as vijnanamaya kosha abhimani. He thinks himself as vijnanamaya kosha itself, because he thinks himself as an individual. That is the idea there. Iti avasthanam, that is the third hetu. Tebhya hetubhya ityartha. These are the three hetus. Tarhi pranastesi iti shrute kurtha tatraha. Guru Pakshi says, okay, all these hetus you have given, then, but what is the meaning of this adhyakshe? If you say adhyakshe jive, that is the meaning of tejasi, then what is the meaning of the shruti at all? Tadvat tejasi pranasya vrittilaya is what I claim. You say vrittilaya or swarupalaya, it is into jiva. Now my question is, pranas tejasi, what is the meaning of that shruti? Kortaha. What is the idea when it brings up tejas at all, the shruti? So Siddhanti says, Bhuteshu tachrutehe, Bhuteshu tachrutehe. So fifth sutra, gives an uttara to that akshepsa also, which continues. Pranas tejasi, what is the meaning? Why tejas word has been used? So Siddhanti says, unto these bhutas is where the jiva has in its karya, really, in the bhuta sukshma, which is the sukshma bhuta karya of the indriyas and indriyadi, sukshma sharira components, which is really sukshma sharira, which is really continuing anadi kalena, it is continuing, but in bija rupa it is there, therefore it has to be remanifest as per the prarabdha into particular sharira, where particular kind of sukshma sharira should be there, some indriyas should function in particular manners based on whether it is human being, what kind of a human being, how the mind should be configured, based on that everything has to be reconfigured in each and every janma. Therefore across kalpa also it is in bija rupa, and folded back into jiva in bija rupa, the sukshma sharira is still there, that is how he is still jiva, samsari jiva. So this bhutas do continue, and therefore bhuteshu tachrute, bhuteshu meaning bhuteshu upahitatvena vidyamane jive, that is the idea, bhutas are still there, when jivas are there, jivas are continuing their journey, so long these bhutas will also be there, which are making up the sukshma sharira. So that is indicated by the tejas shabda there, therefore tachrute, sachruti is there. We'll see in the vritti what exactly it means. Pranas tejasi iti shrute hai tejah saiteshu. There should be tejas, so there should be no gap here. There should be no gap. Tejas saiteshu. So it's a single word. Tejas saiteshu uttara deharambakeshu. So when the jiva is taking janma, Tejas is upalakshana here. Teja means all the sukshma mahabhutas. Upalakshana is what? Swagrahakatve sati tadgrahakatve taditara grahakatvam. Meaning swagrahakatve sati swa itara or anyat grahakatvam. That is upalakshana. So teja here is an upalakshana. It stands for other mahabhutas also. And thereby tejaha meaning all the bhuta sukshma sahita, teja sahiteshu, meaning all the mahabhuta sahita uttara deha arambaka. Unto that there is an abhimana of jiva. So jiva is what? Is teja sahita jiva. Teja, tejadi mahabhuta sukshma sahita jiva. So basically it means sukshma sharira abhimani jiva. And what kind of bhuta sukshmas are these? These are uttara deha arambaka. At the time of death, one knows that I am going to take a particular sharira, because such kind of thinking is going on in the mind. Such samskaras become active to indicate the prarabdha, which will be carved out of sanchita to give this jiva another janma. So uttara deha arambaka are these sukshma mahabhutas. How these mind also will be configured in the next janma, he is, whether he'll be a he or he'll be a she, whether it will be a prani or a bird or a human being or a devata or a rakshasa, whatever gati is there, such kind of configuration starts forming there. Unto that there is this jiva abhimana now, meaning the configuration has changed, but it is the same set of sukshma components. Their configuration is different. That's also uttara deha arambakeshu panchabhuteshu. These are panchamahabhuta sukshmasdo. And upahitatvena. Upahitatvena, because this jiva has this as an upadi, so jiva is upahita. And upahitatvena vidyamane jive. That kind of jiva is what is meant, unto whom this prana has laya. And their pranasya vritti laya ityartha. So swarupalaya or vritti. Swarupalaya, if you say prana is not there, that is the meaning. Therefore vritti laya means in bija avastha it is there. Prana continues. Without prana there cannot be gati also. Going from one sharira to another sharira is also due to this prana. So when purvapakshi says vritti laya, the contrast was done not with vritti laya and swarupalaya, but vritti laya into tejas versus vritti laya into jiva. So that is the difference between Purva Pakshi and the Siddhanti. एवञ्च प्राणस्य उपहित जीव प्राप्तौ उपाधि तेज आदि तेज आदि भूत प्राप्तेः स्वतः सिद्धत्वा इति भावः. सो व्हाई तेजस वाज मेंशन्ड. सो सिद्धांति सेज तेजस इज उपलक्षण फॉर महाभूतास एंड जीवा इज एसोसिएटेड विद दिस महाभूतास सूक्ष्म बिकॉज दिस सूक्ष्म अंशास आर गोइंग टू क्रिएट अ सूक्ष्म शरीर इन द नेक्स्ट जन्म ऑल्सो. दे आर गोइंग टू कॉन्फिगर नॉट क्रिएट बट कॉन्फिगर दिस सूक्ष्म शरीर. सो प्राणस्य उपहित जीव प्राप्तो. When prana is already an upadhi for this jiva, so pranasya upahita jiva praptau satyam upadhi teja adi bhuta prapte. So prana is an upadhi for jiva and this upahita jiva. So prana attains this upahita jiva. What is the upadhi? Prana is an upadhi already, but here what is indicated is upadhi or teja adi bhuta, mahabhutas. So sukshma sharira bhuta sukshma are the upadhi of the jiva. So if upahita jiva is attained by prana, prana merges into that, or prana vritti is merged into this upahita jiva, then upadhi bhuta are already also attained. Because upahita jiva attains, then without the upadhi, prana is not attaining this jiva. So when jiva is attained, jiva is already upahita. Therefore upadhi bhuta are also प्राप्ता देर. सो प्राप्ता प्राप्ते है स्वतः सिद्धत्वात्. इट इज ऑलरेडी स्वतः सिद्ध. देयरफॉर श्रुति मेंशन्स तेजसी टू मीन जीवा ऑल्सो बिकॉज प्राणा मर्जिस विद दी उपाधिज वेर दी उपहित जीवा इज ऑलरेडी कनेक्टेड. देयरफॉर जीवा इज द मीनिंग वाया द उपाधि तेज आदि महाभूतास इति भाव. दिस इज द आइडिया वाई श्रुति टॉक्स अबाउट प्राणस तेजसी इत्यादि. The next adhikarana is asrutyo. Before that, so before that there is a last sutra. Nanu pranastesi iti ekasya eva tejasa shravanat katham tejasaiteshu bhuteshu ityuktam tatraha. Now Purvapakshi is objecting, when tejasi is a singular, why do you say tejasaiteshu uttara deha arambekeshu ityadi bhuteshu? Or in the sutra itself, he says in the bhuteshu teja is one bhuta. Why do you take all the pancha mahabhutas or in trivitkaranam three mahabhutas? Why would you say tejas sahita bhuteshu? Why not say only tejasi? Shruti says tejasi. So to that, the Siddhanti answers, tatraha, to that effect he answers, naikasmin darshayato hi, naikasmin darshayato hi, na ekasmin tejasi. The prana does not merge into vrittilaya, is not into tejas, it is into jiva who is associated with tejas, etc. Jiva is not associated only with tejas, he is associated with all mahabhutas, all sukshmas of mahabhutas, not a single indriya, not a single karya of the mahabhutas. He has association with the conglomerate, the complete set of indriyas and manaha, buddhi, ityadi, all put together including prana. So all the koshas which make up the sukshma sharira and all the components of the koshas which make up the sukshma sharira, there he has abhimana, not into individual components and not only into one tejas or tejas karya. If you say tejas, tejas karya will be what? Tejas karya will be chakshu. So it is not that there is abhimana only in that. So na ekasmin, ekasmin tejasi न दर्शयत ही श्रुति. श्रुति शोज एंड वी हैव सीन दिस इन दी रौहति अधिकरण दिस हैज कम अप. सो वृत्ति इज गोइंग टू से दैट एकस्मिन् एव तेजसि उत्क्रांति समये जीवः न अवतिष्ठते. द जीवा इज नॉट एसोसिएटेड ओनली विथ तेजस महाभूत बट विथ ऑल द महाभूतास विच हैव विच मेक अप द सूक्ष्म शरीर उत्तर देहस्य पांच भौतिकत्वेन बिकॉज उत्तर देह आर पंच भौतिक. They are fivefold. Therefore, panchasu bhuteshu avasthitehe avashyakatvat. The jiva should be associated with all the five. Only then he can have sukshma also as stula sharira also as karya in the next janma, when there is samsarana. And darshayatohi imamartham rauhatyadikarane vyakhyate. Darshata is darshayataha. So these two are shown. Darshayata is dvivachana there. So both are shown. Shruti has shown both. Shrutya darshayate. सो प्रश्नोत्तरो दर्शयतः श्रुत्या नॉट श्रुति श्रुत्या सो सिंस दर्शयतः दीज टू आर शोन इज द मीनिंग देयर देयरफॉर बाय श्रुति इट हैज बीन शोन दर्शयतः ही जस्ट गिव मी अ मोमेंट लेट मी क्रॉस चेक दिस as to there is nothing else given there let's see in the see darshayata hi imam artham ramatyadikane vyakhyate prashna nirupane ityartha darshayata let me just cross check anyway I want to be I don't want to make this mistake if there is any other anurti vritti possible there not anurti but vritti possible there Someone says something else, I'll make a correction. Darshayati. Somebody says both Shruti and Smriti show. So here we don't have such Shruti. In Bhashya there is Darshayati is taken as both Shruti and Smriti. Let me see if there is any other possibility here because by Vritti it does not give that kind of a sense being short. So. Yeah, so darshayata, shruti and smriti, you can take that meaning because in the vritti, there is, although it is not mentioned, we'll keep with the bhashya and there is nothing to contradict also, nothing else has been said. So earlier I said shruti hi, so we'll continue with that, shruti hi smritischa darshayataha. So because karmani is not working anyway, so that was my thinking, darshayata cannot be karmani there. So darshayata is the shruti and they show so it will be causative there darshi dhatu so darshayatah would mean the two of them show so prashna and nirupana or prashna and uttara if we take they show would not make sense prashna nirupane is in the answer to the prashna so it is saptami there so what we can do is that we'll say ekas na ekasmin tejasi जीवस्य वी कैन से जीवस्य जीवः न अवतिष्ठते सो एकस्मिन् न अवतिष्ठते और जीवस्य अभिमानः एकस्मिन् तेजसि न नास्ति वाय श्रुति ही स्मृतिश्च दर्शयति ही सो ही कैन बी टेकन यस्मात् कारणात् दर्शयति दर्शयतः ही श्रुति ही श्रुति स्मृति यू कैन टेक द्विवचन आल्सो बिकॉज द्विवचन इज देयर च इज आल्सो ऑल राइट बट अदरवाइज वी कैन टेक श्रुति ही श्रुति स्मृति दीर्घ श्रुति एंड स्मृति बोथ शो दर्शयता शो सो दर्शयता इज दर्शी धातु निजंत इट इज पॉजिटिव सो इट शोज शोज वॉट शोज दैट तेजस इज नॉट द ओनली कॉम्पोनेंट वेयर जीवा हैज अभिमान इट इज ऑल द पंच महाभूत वेयर वन हैज अभिमान देयर बाय इन सूक्ष्म शरीर एंड एक्सटेंडेड टू स्थूल शरीर विच आर ऑल भूत कार्यास पंच महाभूत कार्यास इंद्रियाज ऑल्सो मनस ऑल्सो बुद्धि ऑल्सो एंड स्थूल शरीर ऑल्सो देर वाय पांच भौतिकत्वेन पंचसु भूतेषु अवस्थिते आवश्यकत्वात् दैट इज डेफिनेटली द नेसेसिटी हियर वी कैन नॉट शो एनी एसोसिएशन विथ तेजस ओनली क्रिएट्स दिस जीवा टू हैव संसार बिकॉज स्थूल शरीर एंड ऑल द सूक्ष्म शरीर अलोंग विथ इंद्रियास आर मेड अप ऑफ डिफरेंट कॉम्पोनेंट्स नॉट ओनली तेजस एंड इमम अर्थम रौहत्यधिकरणे व्हाट हैज गॉन बाय लॉन्ग बैक व्याख्याते प्रश्न निरूपणे इत्यर्थ सो इट हैज बीन शोन देयर सो वी आर नॉट गोइंग एंड दिस इज ऑल वेरी वेल नोन सो वील नॉट रिविजिट दैट श्रुति ही स्मृति श्रुति स्मृति दर्शयत और श्रुतिश्च स्मृतिश्च दर्शयत दिस इज हाउ वील कीप दी वृत्ति इन कीपिंग विद द भाष्य ऑल्दो हियर इट इज नॉट सो क्लियर वील कीप इट दैट वे Now this adhikarana is over. Next adhikarana is asrutyupakramadi adhikaranam. So asrutyupakramadhikaranam. Upakrama of asruti upakrama. Asruti is in samsarana. So up to samsarana. Up to samsarana, the gati of the ajnani and the jnani is the same. Upasaka. Then there is difference. So this is going to be considered in the current upcoming adhikarana. पूर्वोक्त उत्क्रांतिम उपजीव्य अन्यत किंचित विचार्यते इति उपजीव्य उपजीवक भाव संगत्य इदम सो विषय कंटिन्यूस बेस्ड ऑन दी अर्लियर अधिकरण द नेक्स्ट वन इज कमिंग अप देयरफॉर देयर इज उपजीव्य उपजीवक भाव भाव संगति समानाचा श्रुत्युपक्रमाद अमृतत्वंचानुपोष्य समानाचा श्रुत्युपक्रमाद अमृतत्वंचानुपोष्य। सो पूर्वपक्षी कम्स अप विथ समथिंग दैट विल सी फर्स्ट एंड देन विल सी एट द मीनिंग हियर। द आश्रुति च पदच्छेद है समाना च आश्रुति आ इज सेपरेट आ समंता सो आ श्रुति ही आश्रुत्युपक्रमा सो नॉट आश्रुति आश्रुत्युपक्रमा सो समाना च आ श्रुत्युपक्रमा पंचमी बिकॉज आ समंता अप टू देयर इज अ अवधि दैट अवधि इज going to need a panchami, that panchami is srutyupakramad and then amrutatvam cha anuposhya, this is a padachheda. What is the meaning there? Asrutyupakramad up to upakrama of the samsarana. So samsarana upasaka will have devayana or uttarayana leading to brahmaloka, uttarayana gati. So that is the difference later. So before the path splits up for the ajnani and the jnani, whether jnani is upasaka jnani or brahma jnani, nirguna brahma jnani, where there is no upakrama at all, there is no leaving the sharira at all, but that is going to be inquired later. So we'll keep as the vidyavan, whether it is nirguna brahma vidyavan or saguna brahma vidyavan, upasaka or jnani, he is separated out from the ajnani who has gati. So upasaka will have gati. As per the Purvapakshi, everyone will have gati. Let's assume that. Or everyone will not have gati. That is also another Purvapaksha that will come up based on the context. And then there may be Punarjanma. However, at least upasaka and ajnani are seen together. That should not be the case, says the Siddhanti. He says samana cha asrutyupakramat. Asrutyupakramat cha, meaning devayana or the dakshinayana versus uttarayana. So uttarayana upakramat prak, basically gatikramat prak, before the gatikramat amrutatvancha anuposhya. So before we land there, what is this? Samana, the saguna vidvad and avidvad. Saguna meaning upasaka avidushoho utkrantihi samana eva. That is the first part till panchami upakramat. Meaning what? Asrutyupakramat cha prag utkrantihi samana eva. Kayoho samana utkrantihi. Travel before the travel path splits into Dakshinayana Marga, Dakshina Marga or Uttarayana Marga, whose travel is similar till then, of the Upasaka and the Avidvan. Then Purvapakshi is going to ask, wait, why will there be Utkranti similar, meaning the Gati, the path splits and you are saying still Upasaka will have a Gati like Ajnani. So Purvapakshi says, how can there be utkranti for the upasaka? Because amrutatva has been mentioned. This upasaka will get amrutatva. If he gets amrutatva, why will he have gati? Why will he have gati? Why will he travel? You are saying he'll travel to Brahmaloka, but why should he travel to Brahmaloka? Because amrutatva can be here. As soon as he dies, he will get amrutatva. Meaning, the utkranti, the travel, although it is different by different paths, it is common as per the, meaning the travel is still there. This is the commonality between the ajnani and the upasaka. Purvapakshi says, no, there is no travel involved for the upasaka. Why should he travel? Amrutatva has been mentioned. So amrutatva is both ways. Purvapakshi says amrutatva is there. Siddhanti says, no, that amrutatvancha. What about that amrutatvam? Purvapakshi says amrutatvancha anuposhya apakshikam eva. Anuposhya means without adagdva, without burning. What? Avidyadi. Without avidyadi being burnt, upasaka cannot burn away his avidya. Avidya will still be there. Because he thinks he is a jiva who will travel, he may have done ahangraha upasana of brahma, nirguna brahma upasana also he may have done, but he has no understanding that how he is non different from brahma. Therefore avidya is still there. He still considers himself as separate from the upasya brahma. Therefore anuposhya meaning adagdva, without having turned the ajnana into ashes, without ajnana going away, amrutatvancha kim apekshikam eva. It is relative amrutatvam, it is not amrutatvam. Brahmaloka stay will be very 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 large. Duration that one stays in brahmaloka and the sukha will be extremely great. There is nothing better than that in loka, in no loka. In swargaloka also you can't stay as much as you can stay in brahmaloka, and you cannot have so much of ananda as in brahmaloka, be it in swargadi, pitruloka, swargaloka, any loka. Therefore apekshika amrutattvam, in comparison to others it is amruta. Compared to this prithviloka, the stay in pitruloka is also can be called as amruta, because one gets dirghayu. So dirghayu is amruta, considered as amruta. So it is all apekshika compared to that swarga, compared to that all these other lokas, higher and higher lokas, finally brahmaloka. But because brahmaloka will also resolve in kalpa, after the end of kalpa, even brahma, chaturmukha brahma, as long as he is there, although he is there for his 100 years, which are entire kalpa for us, across so many thousands of years, but still it is not mukhya amrutatva, it is only apekshika amrutatva. That is the sutra artha. Atra purvapakshe dhaharadyupasakasya utkrantya bhavad ihaiva muktihi. Purvapakshi says here itself the upasaka, dhahar upasaka will have mukti here itself. He will not have utkranti. So utkranti abhavad ihaiva mukti. There is no utkranti and that will become hetu for mukti here itself. Siddhanti tu utkranti sadbhavad brahmaloka praptiriti phalabhedaha. Siddhanti says upasakas cannot have amrutattvam and mukti here. He will travel to brahmaloka. So brahmaloka prapti, why? Utkranti sadbhava, there will definitely utkranti, travel is involved. From the sharira, he has to leave the sharira and go. Just like the other jiva who is an ajnani, he will also leave the sharira and go. Kim utkranti ravidusha eva uta dharadi saguna brahma upasakasya api iti samshaye tayordhvamayan namrutattvameti ityupasakasya moksha shravanat avidusha eva iti purvapaksha. So when the doubt comes up as to whether the avidvan has utkranti, ajnani, only that avidvan has utkranti, or dharadi saguna brahma upasaka also, whether dahara upasana, hangra upasana is doing with dahara, or aditya ityadi, nirguna brahma also possible. Saguna has been mentioned, nirguna brahma upasana can also be added here, adi padena. So upasaka will have utkranti or not, will he have gati? Iti samshe, purvapakshi quotes, tayordhvamayan amrutattvameti. So taya urdhvamayan amrutattvameti, having left his sharira via the VAC nadis also, which are going to come up, which have gone by also. This Katha Upanishad says that person, upasaka, will not have gati. Why? Amrutattvameti has been mentioned. So urdhvamayan amrutattvameti, that is a pramana there. This saguna brahma will not have utkramana, he'll have amrutattva, meaning he'll attain mukti here and now. Iti upasakasya moksha shravanat, amrutattva is moksha. So moksha shravanat avidusha eva iti purvapaksha. Avidusha eva kim? Avidusha eva kim utkranti. Utkranti hi. So what will be there? Avidusha eva utkranti hi. That is how the anvaya will be. Avidusha eva utkranti hi bhavati natu upasakasya. That is the purvapaksha. Siddhantastu asrutyupakramat देवयान उपक्रमात् प्राक् या इयम् उत्क्रांतिः सा विद्वद् अविदुषोः समाना एव भवितुम् अर्हति. इट इज नॉट दैट द उपासका विल गेट मुक्ति हियर इन दिस बॉडी और एट द ड्रॉप ऑफ द बॉडी, ही ऑल्सो हैव उत्क्रमण, ही लीव द शरीर जस्ट लाइक the Ajnani, and then till the path splits into Brahmaloka and wherever the other jivas are traveling, whether it is Dakshina Marga or Uttara Marga. In fact, if somebody is going to Swarga in the same Marga, the Ajnani will also travel, but then it will split into Brahmaloka later and Swargaloka. So till then there is a common path. So Utkramana is, Utkranti is Samana. Samana eva bhavitum arhati. Kuta why so asked the Purva Pakshi, Vang Manasi ityadya visheshe sharvana. Because Vang Manasi sampadyate, Manav Prane, that all that is common. There is no vishesha as to whether it is for an Ajnani or the Upasaka. It is a common statement with respect to all. Nanu katham tari saguna vidyaya amrutatva sharvanam iti tatraha. What about this amrutatva mentioned in the Shruti that I quoted as the Purva Pakshi for the saguna vidya upasaka? To that Siddhanti answers amrutatvancha anuposhya. So you have to have some padas to make the anvaya clear. So anuposhya means adagdva, without having burnt. Tva pratyaya is there, adagdva, not having burnt what? Having not burnt what? Atyantam avidya klesha jalam. The avidya klesha, avidya itself is klesha and avidya karya is also klesha. So avidya and klesha, or avidya krita klesha, or avidya itself is klesha. All sorts of understanding can be there. The entire jala, entire samuha, which is atyanta, which will not go unless jnana takes place. Therefore, atyantam avidya klesha jalam. And you can say atyantam adagdva. Atyantam can be seen as kriya visheshana to adagdva. So avidya klesha jalam atyantam adagdva. Without completely burning that avidya, if avidya klesha lesha is also there, then etad amrutattvam apekshikam mityartha. Without burning avidya, avidya continuing, one cannot have amrutattva at all. There is no mukti possible. There is only one marga for mukti, and that is avidya nasha. And avidya will go only by vidya. Which vidya? Nirguna brahma vidya, not upasana, but jnana proper. Samshaya rahita manana siddha jnana, where nishtha is better. Even that is much better, because there will be jivan mukti. Otherwise, videha mukti only. So, etad amrutattvam, which amrutattvam? Upasakasya amrutattvam apekshikam eva. It is relative amrutattva. It is not real immortality. It is relative immortality. The next adhikarana is samsara vyapadesha adhikaranam. The introduction to that goes as, nanu utkranti samana iti ayuktam. Oh, how is it that this upasaka and Ajnani will have same or similar utkramana, utkranti? Why will both leave the sharira? Mrutasya swarupata eva atyantam brahma sampattehe iti akshepa sangatya idamaha. So Purvapakshi says, this mrutaha, even the, there is no utkranti even for this, a different Purvapaksha. He says that the person who is dying, whether he is a jnani or an ajnani, why will they have upakrama at all, utkranti, utkramana at all, utkranti? Utkranti is not there even for a person who is dying. Whether he is a jnani or ajnani is irrelevant. So to that he gives some kind of a pramana. Why? Because atyantam brahma sampatte swarupata eva mrutasya. The person who is dying is, by swarupa he is brahma. Then the laya will be in brahma. Why will anyone travel? No one should travel. So this is a very odd kind of a Purva Paksha, where he is saying that everyone will have mukti, because by swarupa we are all brahma. So you see, you know, then the Neo Vedanta also, you see this kind of thinking. Oh, tattvamasi aham brahmasmi, this is well known. So we all are nothing but brahma. We are not separate from brahma. So why will we have gati? Nobody will have gati. So you die, the sharira is there, prarabdha nasha will take place, sharira will go away, and then mrutasya swarupata eva atyantam brahma sampatte attains brahma itself. Shruti says so. So they'll quote some shruti, which we'll see as to Purva Pakshi quoting it, and then therefore what iti akshepa sangatya. Akshepa sangati is there. He raises a doubt, saying that some Purva Pakshi is sitting there. He says that absolutely no travel is there for anyone. Forget utkranti samana between ajnani and upasaka. Even the ajnani will not travel. Why? Because in swarupa is brahma. So he is going to quote, and in brahma itself there is sampatti. There is attainment of brahma itself shown by shruti. And thereby samsara vyapadeshadikam. There is teaching of samsara. Samsarana continues. For an ajnani, samsarana continues. If the Siddhanti is going to say, if at all there is attainment of Brahma in the mukhya sense for even an ajnani after the drop of the body, then there will be no samsarana possible. Brahma cannot have samsara. So if the jiva, who is a samsari, merges into, in a primary sense, if he merges into Parabrahma, who is asamsari, then how will he get another janma? That is not possible. Samsara is taught in the Shastra for an ajnani. Therefore, this kind of a meaning, even if it is read in some Shruti, it is not in the primary sense. It is not in, it has to be understood in the context. Thereby, Bhagavan Sutrakara says, Tadapite samsara vipadesha, tadapite samsara vipadesha. So, apitehe, tad, tat, apitehe, that is, there are three words in tadapitehe, tat, and apitehe. Apita is moksha, apiti is moksha, apitehe is panchami, so amokshat, tat. What is tat? Tat is tejaha. So, tat tejaha, apitehe, amokshat. What? Samsara vipadeshat hetoho avatishtate. So this tat tejas, meaning the teja adi mahabhutas which have made the sukshma sharira, that sukshma sharira is still there. If sukshma sharira is there, the pratibimba or the abhimana in that is also continuing. Even after death, the abhimana in the sukshma sharira does not go. It will go only by jnana. So the jnana not taking place, the person who is dying, whether he is an upasaka or an ajnani, Upasaka is also an ajnani here, but plain ajnani meaning one who has not done upasana and one who has done upasana, they may have different gatis, but still they'll have gati. So tad apithe samsara vipade, because samsara teaching is there. There is samsara taught for the ajnani. Therefore, it is not that the jiva will merge into parabrahma at death. Atra purvokshe mrutamatrasya mukti. Somebody dies, that's it, that is mukti. As per the Purva Bhakshi, Siddhanti Tadabhava iti Phalaveda, meaning Muktiya Bhava Tatpadena Mukti, Muktiya Bhava iti Phalaveda. Siddhanti says there is no Mukti, it is not, you are distributing chocolates to kids, that Mukti will be given out to every Tom, Dick and Harry. You have to take an effort in Shravana Mana Nididhyasana, then alone there is Mukti via Ajnana Nasha. Tejav Parasyam Devatayam Ityatra Sadhyaksham, meaning Adhyakshena Jivena Saha. Sadhyaksham bhutantara sahitam tejaha paramatmani sampadyate tejasolaya shruyate. Purvapakshi says, but you are having shruti virodha. How so? In shruti it is seen, tejaha parasyam devatayam, and you have explained tejas is what? All the mahabhutas, bhutasukshmas. So all that, where there is abhimana of jiva, so jiva will merge into parasyam devatayam. So tejasi, when Pranas Tejasi was read in the same Chandogya Shruti, in the same section, you said that Tejaha means Teja Sahita Mahabhuta Adhyaksha Jiva. Unto that Jiva. So Tejasi means Jive, Adhyakshe Jive. Similarly, Teja will mean what? Tejas will mean Teja Sahita Mahabhuta. So Pancha Mahabhuta Adhyaksha Jivaha. So that jiva will, sadhyaksham jiva will be the meaning there. So this jiva parasyam devatayam sampadyate. So the paradevata, parabrahma is where this jiva will merge. That is what the Shruti is saying sakshat. You just go a mantra ahead, you will see ityatra sadhyaksham adhyakshena saha jivena saha sadhyaksham bhutantara sahitam teja. So tejas is what? Not teja, it is sadhyaksham teja, meaning along with jiva, sajivam tejaha, because it is neuter, tejas is neuter. Therefore, adhyakshena jivena saha vartate iti sadhyaksham, who? Tejas, that tejas. And tejas is what? Bhutantara sahitam, it is along with other mahabhutas. That kind of tejas, meaning the jiva, along with jiva, this tejas is merging into paramatma. Paramatmani, why? Parasyam devatayam, which is paramatma. So paramatmani sampadyate iti tejasa laya shruyate. How will you counter this shruti as to jiva along with mahabhutas merges into परमात्मा हैज बीन मेंशन बाय द सेम छांदोग्य श्रुति षष्ठो अध्याय श्रुति स किम आत्यंतिक उत अनात्यंतिक इति संशय इज आत्यंतिक लय और अनात्यंतिक लय दैट डाउट विल कम अप इफ इट इज आत्यंतिक देन मुक्ति एज पर पूर्व पक्षी सिद्धांत से अनात्यंतिक अनात्यंतिक देयर फॉर संसार उपदेश दिस संसार विल कंटिन्यू फॉर सच जीव हु मर्जिस देयर वाय परमात्मनः सर्व उपादानत्वात् तत्र आत्यंतिक एव लयः इति पूर्वपक्ष पूर्वपक्षी सेज दैट परमात्मा इज उपादान फॉर एवरीथिंग नॉट ओनली फॉर तेजस बट ऑल महाभूतास एंटायर प्रपंच हैज अधिकरण इन द फॉर्म ऑफ उपादान कारण अभिन्न निमित्त उपादान कारण इज परमात्मा एज पर सिद्धांति ऑल्सो एज पर वेदांत इट्सेल्फ देयरफॉर लया इनटू परमात्मा विल बी आत्यंतिक लयः इट विल बी कंप्लीट लय देर इट इज नॉट टेम्पररी इट इज परमानेंट आत्यंतिक इज परमानेंट लय देर फॉर वॉट विल हैपन देर विल बी नो संसार देर विल बी मुक्ति फॉर ऑल जीवास एनी जीवा हु डाइज ही विल हैव मुक्ति टू दैट इज सिद्धांति सेज इट इज नॉट सो वाई सिद्धांत अस्तु तत् यथा उदीरितम तेजा द वे यू एक्सप्लेन तेजा विल एक्सेप्ट दैट तेजा आपीते हे आ मोक्षाद अवतिष्ठते बिफोर मोक्षा दैट जीवा विल हैव संसार He remains. He cannot have atyanta laya in Paramatma. Why? Kutaha yoni manye prapadyante shariratvaya dehina. Katashruti says that shariratvaya for shariratvam to attain sharira under sharira dehina. This dehina deha asya astiti dehi. And in plural it will become dehinaha. So dehinaha prapadyante kim prapadyante योनिम अन्ये देहिनः योनिम प्रपद्यन्ते दे अटेन डिफरेंट योनि दे अटेन योनि अनदर फ्रॉम अनदर जन्म बेसिकली दैट्स व्हाट इट मींस व्हाई शरीरत्वाय टू गेट अनदर शरीर अनलेस दे आर बोर्न दे कैन नॉट टेक इन अ वूम और एन एग और समथिंग दे कैन नॉट टेक अप द शरीर सो शरीरत्वाय फॉर दैट पर्पस अलोन दे विल टेक जन्म आफ्टर जन्म दैट इज ए कटश्रुति अनलेस देर इज ज्ञान You cannot have mukti ityadina samsara vyapadeshat. So ajnani dehinaha jivasya samsara vyapadesha. Samsara teaching is there. Samsarana is there. One will keep on attaining yoni after yoni, janma after janma, then marana after marana. So janma marana will continue. Anyatha what will happen? Anyatha punah samsara bhavaha prasajyeta. Otherwise what will happen? If there is atyantalaya then there will be no samsara. And then there will be katashruti virodha. Therefore, we agree that there is laya, but laya is not atyantika, it is apekshika or anatyantika. Tasma shushupta uiva, just like in shushupti, in nidra also, shushupti avastha also, one merges with the same paramatma, that one merges after death. Why does one wake up if there is atyanta laya? As the siddhanti. So therefore, tasma shushupta uiva, like deep sleep, similarly is the mrityu, therefore, Death is called as sleep and Sushupti is called as Nitya Pralaya also. So in Pralaya, Mrityu and in Sushupti, in all three, there is merging into Paramatma with the Bija hanging. So na Atyantika Layaha iti Siddham. There is no Atyantika Laya. Because if you look at, in fact, there is an example that one Swamiji gives. So, in Rishi Kailashashram Swamiji gives an example. He says, the Ganga water in Rishikesh is very cold. In all seasons, it will be cold because Himalayas are very near and the Ganga is flowing from there. So, in Mother Ganga, the Ganga waters, what people do is that it is, you know, like a fridge temperature. So, where they have lot of, food or something, milk. So, milk is there, lot of milk is there. So what they do is that the milk will get spoiled. They want the milk to be used the next day. So what they do is that they put in a drum, they tie it with a chain, a nicely sealed drum, and then they throw the drum in Ganga. It will remain cold. It will remain as fresh. Next day they'll pull it out. So in Sushupti, Marana, and Kalpa, end of Kalpanta, This is how the jiva is thrown into Paramatma, so to say, figuratively. with the chain of avidya which is hanging on. So the jiva will be pulled out when the time is right to wake up or to get another janma or when another cycle of srishti starts. So this jiva, each and every jiva will be pulled out with avidya chain. Chain is still there. Only if we, you know, the chain snaps off, then it is possible. But like the example, chain cannot snap off. You have to cut it with jnana. So avidya will go only with vidya. Therefore, yoni manye prapadyante is the pramana for samsara. There cannot be mukti just like that. Nanu uktalakshanam tejaha yadyasti. Yadi asti. If at all such kind of tejas is there where jiva has abhimana, tarhi parshvastaihi upalabhyeta ityah. Purva Pakshi says, what is this tejas? Tejas is prakasha rupa and it is in the form of heat also. So Purva Pakshi is looking at prakasha now, which should be visible now. Tejas is prakasha rupa. If jiva has abhimana in this tejas and tejas continues to be there, tejas avatishtate has been said, tejaha avatishtate, then you have to explain why is it not seen by others. Parshvastehi upalabhyeta, it would be seen by others also. Why don't others see? So the person who is dying, then also people don't see tejas, and the person who is dead, there also after that we don't see this tejas. What is this tejas? Ask the Purva Pakshi. So it is said in Smriti or something, loha pashena kalena sneha pashena bandubihi. The person who is dying sees light. Actually, he sees light to guide him into the next janma. The person, the jiva who is dying. However, what happens is that there is pasha, ubhaya pasha. Both sides there is a pasha, there is a rope tied, and both sides he is being pulled. Not rope, pasha is loha pasha. So by the loha pasha kalena, kala is yamaraja or yamaduta, they pull this person with a loha pasha, with an iron chain. Because his next janma is due, they are pulling him, oh, go to the next janma. And this person has attachments, sneha pasha. He has the rope in the, he is bound by sambandha. Oh, these are my people, this is my children, this is my wife or whatever, spouse. These are my relatives, I have so much to do. So sneha pasha is dragging. So this person is in a fix. He is pulled from both sides. So suffers a lot. Nobody really fears death. Everyone fears the process of death. That is dukkha karaka, pida karaka. So bandhus are pulling sneha pashena bandhubi and lo pashena kalena yamarajena yamadutena va. Thereby this person on the deathbed, although he sees jyoti, he is not able to go. Some kind of a jyoti is assumed there. However, the Purva Pakshi is asking, this person is tejo rupa. You are saying that this jiva is associated with tejas. Why do others not see? To that, Bhagavan Sutrakara answered, Sukshmam pramanatascha tato palabdehe. Sukshmam pramanatascha tato palabdehe. So Siddhanti says, it is sukshma teja. It is not tejas as in it is the fire that you see here in this loka. It is not that kind of fire. It is sukshma tejas. It is bhuta sukshma, we already mentioned. But it is not clear to the Purva Pakshi. Therefore, Siddhanti says, sukshmam pramanataha. Pramanata means by pramana, mana also. By size also it is sukshma. Teja is not like this fire that you see, a forest fire. It is sukshma and it is pramanata sukshma also. By size also it is sukshma. Pramanatascha sukshma. It is already subtle, subtle mahabhuta and bhuta sukshma. And it is also what? In size also, when it is manifest in the body also, it is in a small size. Therefore, it cannot be seen. So this jiva who has association with teja, when he travels with sukshma sharira, which is not having a huge size like the body. He is going to travel with a very small small kind of a portion, which is where it is folded back like a bija, and then he has traveled. Tatha upalabde. So sukshmam pramanataha cha tatha upalabdehe. That is a padachheda. So upalabdehe is tatha upalabde, together is a hetu. Tatha means tatha sukshmatvasya. Sukshmatvasya upalabdehe. Since that is upalabda, how it is upalabda, we see in the vritti. Yathoktam tejaha pramanataha chakara swarupatascha. So by size and swarupa, tejas is what? Sukshma, yathoktam. The way it has been mentioned, that tejas where jiva has association. So jiva sahita, adhyaksha, sadhyaksham teja is what? इज त्रसेरुणवत सूक्ष्म त्रसेरणु सॉरी त्रसे त्रसरेणु त्रसरेणु त्रस त्रस त्रसरेहे अणुवत त्रसरेहे अणुवत सूक्ष्म सो त्रसरेहे अणुवत मीन्स त्रेणुकवत लाइक दी तार्किक एक्सप्लेन दैट एग्जाम्पल इज टेकन इज ये अणु विजिबल टू द आय नॉट अणुज आर विजिबल टू आय सो अप टू त्रसरे अप टू दी एटम बिकमिंग थ्री थ्री फोल्ड हाउ थ्री फोल्ड वन एटम कंबाइन्स विथ वन परमाणु सो एटम इज जनरिक ट्रांसलेशन देर बट वन परमाणु कंबाइन्स विथ अनदर परमाणु इट बिकम्स द्वेणुक दैट इज नॉट विजिबल टू द आई सो परमाणु एज वेल एज द्वेणुक आर नॉट विजिबल टू द आईज आफ्टर त्रेणुक इट इज विजिबल सो अप टू दिस त्रेणुक इट इज नॉट विजिबल टू द नेकेड आई सिमिलरली इज दिस सूक्ष्म तेज तस्य नाड़ी द्वारा निष्क्रमण श्रुत्या तथा सूक्ष्मत्वस्य उपलब्धे इत्यर्थ इन श्रुति यू सी स्टेटमेंट्स एज टू दी सूक्ष्म तेज सो तेजस जीव अलॉन्ग विद दैट ट्रेवल्स सूक्ष्म शरीर ट्रेवल्स वाया नाड़ी बिकॉज वी हैव सीन अर्लियर दिस ब्रह्मलोका ट्रेवल इज ऑल्सो वाया नाड़ी सो दी जीवा टू ट्रेवल वाया नाड़ी विद दि सूक्ष्म शरीर सूक्ष्म शरीर हैज टू बी इन साइज ऑल्सो इट शुड बी सूक्ष्म सूक्ष्म एंड स्वरूप ऑल्सो सो निष्क्रमण श्रुत्या बिकॉज निष्क्रमण श्रुति इज देर हाउ द ट्रेवल इज मेन्शन वाया नाड़ी सो नाड़ी इज वेरी सूक्ष्म ऑफ अ वेरी स्मॉल साइज सो तथा सूक्ष्मत्वस्य उपलब्धे इत्यर्थः एंड वॉट नो उपमर्देन अतः नो उपमर्देन अतः सो न उपमर्देन अतः अतः मीन्स देर फॉर अलोन न वॉट न उपमर्देन कस्य उपमर्देन स्थूल शरीर से उपमर्देन सूक्ष्म सूक्ष्मत्वाद इट इज नॉट दैट दी शरीर डाइंग दी सूक्ष्म शरीर विल नॉट डाई विल ऑल्सो डाय सॉरी सूक्ष्म शरीर विल ऑल्सो डाय इट्स अ वेरी स्मॉल वृत्ति अतः सूक्ष्मत्वादेव शरीर उपमर्देन स्थूल शरीर उपमर्देन स्वयं न उपमर्द्यते इत्यर्थः दि सूक्ष्म तेजस आदि विल तेज आदि विल नॉट हैव मरणा लाइक दि स्थूल शरीर इट विल कंटिन्यू सो स्थूल शरीर डाइज स्थूल शरीर इज स्थूल सो इट डाइज बट सूक्ष्म शरीर इज सूक्ष्म सो इट हैज अ गेट अवे इट गोज अवे बिफोर द शरीर इज बर्न्ड the sukshma sharira has already traveled however you destroy the sthula sharira sukshma sharira will always travel with the along with prana with the jiva so therefore alone why because sukshmatvat so ataha is asmat karanat sukshmatvad eva kasya teja teja what has been mentioned tejasaha tejasaha sukshmatvad eva meaning sukshma sharirasya jiva sahitasya sukshmatvad eva sharira upamardena sthula sharira upamardena because स्थूल शरीर हैज गॉन मीनिंग डेड देयर फोर सूक्ष्म शरीर इज नॉट देयर दैट शुड नॉट बी क्लेम्ड सूक्ष्म शरीर मे नॉट बी विजिबल मीन तेजस प्रकाश मे नॉट बी विजिबल इट इज सूक्ष्म बट इट विल ट्रेवल इट विल लिव ऑन अक्रॉस जन्मास दिस इज द 10th सूत्र वी विल लुक एट मोर 11th फ्रॉम द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑनवर्ड्स रादर वी लुक एट नेक्स्ट सूत्र ऑनवर्ड्स इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट आमनयंते संसिद्धम आदिमध्यांत वर्जितम आनंद घनमा पूर्णमात्म ज्योतिरुपासमहे नमस्ते धन्यवाद
नमस्ते।